Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It is nice to have you as my audience, and I really appreciate you, and I pray that Almighty God will visit you and bless you according to your heart desires in Jesus' beautiful, precious name. Amen. Happy Super Good Friday. We are right now jubilating in our hearts because yesterday, Good Friday, our Lord Jesus Christ went on the cross of Calvary to share his precious blood for you and I in order to restore us to our Heavenly Father, in order to make a way for us, in order to give us eternal life, in order to set us free from the bondages of our old masters. Right now, Jesus Christ is our new master. He has come to give us life and life abundant. So, arise to a new hope. Arise to a new hope. Because Jesus Christ has come to give us a new hope. He has come to restore us. He has come to fulfill our purpose, which enemy has stolen in the past. The purpose that God gave us from the beginning, our Lord Jesus Christ has come to restore it. He has given us a new hope by going on cross yesterday. And today, we are waiting patiently. Waiting patiently and depending on our God with great faith. That by tomorrow, this time tomorrow, we are celebrating, jubilating the rising of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will rise again. He will defeat Satan, defeat grave, and defeat death. And he'll conquer unrighteousness. He'll conquer all situations and give us everlasting victory in the name of Jesus. So, my fellow Christians all over the world, arise to a new hope today and be restored in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen, amen, hallelujah, hallelujah. Do you know that the ultimate and complete peace begins with our Lord Jesus Christ? It begins when you have peace with God. If you don't have peace with God, your creator, you are wasting time. So having peace with your creator is very important. Regardless of your past life, regardless of your failure, regardless of what you have gone through, your future is still untapped. Your future is still untapped because Jesus Christ is the center of your life. Jesus Christ is the beginning of your life. He is willing to forgive you and to forget the past. Just ask him wherever you are today. Kneel down while he is right now defeating devils, making open show of all of them in hell, defeating grave and death. Rise up to a new hope and kneel down in the corner of your apartment. Just ask God, please come into my life. Confess Jesus Christ today as your personal savior, as the Lord of your life. He's more than willing to forgive you all you have done in the past and make you his own again and make you co-join with our Lord Jesus Christ. 1 John 4:9 gives us hope about what Jesus is doing for us. 1 John 1:9. So that is something that you have to go and read and see that God has given us a new hope through his son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior. Amen. So if you are a living human being today, and you do not have Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you have not received him as the Lord of your life, rise up to a new hope today. Because Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and life. Matthew 6:33 says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all other things will be added unto you." If you see Jesus Christ, everything you need in this world will be given to you. If you don't have Jesus Christ, your life is empty. Your life is incomplete. Your life is unfulfilled. So rise up to a new hope today and receive our Lord Jesus Christ, who has defeated hell, defeated Satan, defeated unrighteousness, defeated grave, and made open show of all of them. Rise up and make him your best friend. Acquaint yourself with Jesus Christ today and be restored again. Broken relationships with Jesus Christ, broken relationship with God Almighty, or with even your fellow human being, this can lead to broken hearts. So just think about it. When you cannot have a good relationship with your own God, who have created you, your maker, you know that he's the one who have made you in his own image and likeness. And when you are no more, where are you going to? You are going back to the same God. So how can you reject him while you are still alive? No. Live in Christ, die in Christ, and live again forever in Christ, in Jesus' name. For myself, in Christ I live, in Christ I move, and in Christ I have my entire being. I don't know about you, but the promises of God is for those who have believed in him today. Come to him, he will heal your broken hearts. God promises will come to heal you and give you peace that no man gives to you, peace that passes every understanding. Not only does Jesus Christ heal you, he will also restore you full time. He will restore you completely. Read the book of Psalm 147, verses 3. You see that our Jesus Christ is in the business of restoration, restoring his people. He restores me. He restores many who have believed and trusted him today. You too can be restored and be transformed in the name of Jesus. Bible tells us in Romans 12, verses 2, do not conform yourself with the things of this world. Do not conform yourself with the patterns of this world, with the ways of this world. Rise up today to a new hope. Renew your mind. Renew your mind. Be transformed by renewing your mind, and your life will never be the same again. Jesus loves you, and he loves you forever. So you are the only one who will stop Jesus Christ from loving you. So rise up, ladies and gentlemen, and move in spirit, and ask Lord Jesus Christ to come inside you, to forgive you all your sins, to wash you with the blood of Jesus, and make you whole. Because that precious blood of Jesus Christ, he never loses strength, he never loses power, he never expires at all. It's forever and ever. The same blood 2,000 years ago, the same blood will heal you. Come to Jesus Christ. Your life will never be the same again. I've tested him and I see that he is the best. He is the best living God. There's no other living God. Other gods are man-made gods. Other man-made gods, they are dead. Their bones are still in grave. But our Lord Jesus Christ is risen, and he's risen, and he's in heaven right now with our Heavenly Father. So you too can join God's family and be co-joined with our Lord Jesus Christ. I know that I'm here to encourage you, and many of you are still in darkness, but I invite you today to come into the marvelous light of God Almighty, who can see you through, who can give you life everlasting. Don't you know that the Word of God is a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path? With the Word of God, you can excel. With the Word of God, you can be victorious. With the Word of God, you can be hilarious. With the Word of God, you can conquer. With the Word of God, you can overcome. In the name of Jesus. That is why Romans 8, that 7 tells us, yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Be a conqueror today in the name of the Lord our Jesus Christ. And stop wasting time. Stop running away from God who made you. Stop living unbelief life. Stop living unrighteous life. Stop what you are doing right now and befriend Jesus Christ. Make him your best friend, and your life will never be the same. God bless you. I know that this small message will have a change in your life. And I pray that Almighty God, who has made you in his own image and likeness, will come and dwell in you, purify you, change you, transform you, and restore you for his own glory in the name of Jesus. God bless you. Stay tuned. I'll be right back. Remember that it is time to arise to a new hope because of what Jesus Christ did on the cross of Calvary for you and me. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Stay tuned. I love you. Jesus loves you most. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.